Factoring quadratics doesn't have to be frustrating. Once you know a few tricks, you can factor almost any quadratic quickly. By the end of this lesson, you'll know how to handle simple quadratics, tougher ones, and even special cases that you can spot in seconds. Part 1, Simple Quadratics. Let's start with the easier ones. Take this example, x squared plus 7x plus 10. The trick is to look for two numbers that multiply to the constant term, which is the last number, and at the same time add to the middle coefficient. Here we need two numbers that multiply to 10 and add to 7. That pair is 5 and 2. So the factored form is x plus 5 times x plus 2. That's it. Whenever the leading coefficient is 1, just look for two numbers that multiply to the last number and add to the middle. Part 2, harder quadratics with leading coefficient greater than 1. Now, what if the number in front of x squared is not 1? That is where many students get stuck. Let's try 6x squared plus 11x plus 4. Here's the trick. Multiply the first coefficient, which is 6, by the last coefficient, which is 4. That gives 24. Now find two numbers that multiply to 24 and add to the middle number, which is 11. That pair is 3 and 8. Next, split the middle term into those two numbers, 6x squared plus 3x plus 8x plus 4. Now group them, 6x squared plus 3x and 8x plus 4. Factor each group, 3x times 2x plus 1 and 4 times 2x plus 1. Finally, factor out the common binomial, 3x plus 4 times 2x plus 1. And that is your factored form. This is called the AC method. Multiply the first and last, split the middle, then factor by grouping. Works every time. Part 3, Special Cases. Now let's cover some special patterns you can recognize instantly. First, the difference of squares. For example, x squared minus 25. This factors into x minus 5 times x plus 5. Anytime you see a square minus another square, it splits into a sum and a difference. Next, the perfect square trinomial. For example, x squared plus 10x plus 25. Notice the last term is 5 squared and the middle is 2 times 5 times x. That means it factors into x plus 5 squared. Recognizing these shortcuts will save you a lot of time. If the leading coefficient is 1, look for two numbers that multiply to the last term and add to the middle. If the leading coefficient is larger than 1, use the AC method, multiply, split, and group. And always watch for difference of squares and perfect squares. Those are the instant shortcuts. Now you've got all the tricks to factor any quadratic, whether it's simple, tricky, or a special case. Here's a challenge for you. Factor 12x squared plus 7x minus 10. Leave your answer in the comments, and let's see who gets it right first. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.